Back in 2016, I started a project on coloring. I designed a brand new boy, and I colored him using the colors I wanted. Then I found a few artists to color him in using a very vague color key, such as his hair is this brick red orange color, I forgot what I used, his eyes be gold, stuff like that, pretty vague. And if you've been following me for a while, you know that I never posted that project. I don't know why. Don't ask me. I feel very bad about it. That was almost 4 years ago. And I just got this burst of inspiration and I was like, you know what? I can still save this. So I was gonna post a project last month or the month before, something like that. And I contacted some of the artists from that project. And then I was made aware that maybe posting somebody's coloring from 4 months, 4 months, from 4 years ago isn't a very cool idea. I get it now. I mean, all those artists have improved by now. And, you know, posting somebody's old art isn't always the coolest of ideas. So I knew what I had to do. I had to start the project all over again. So I created a brand new boy. Colored him in, again, using the colors that I wanted. And then I actually made the project public this time. I posted it on Twitter saying, hey guys, I have a project. Who wants to volunteer and do this stuff? And then you guys really did, you know, you really helped me out. I got over 70 submissions. That is a 7-0, my guy. That is crazy. Thank you so much to everyone who participated. Definitely didn't think that many people would want to. You see, the point of this coloring project is to show new artists or any artist who, you know, focus a lot on art styles and how they're gonna draw hair and eyes and, you know, just who focus on the drawing aspect of art styles. It's to show them that coloring plays a huge, giant part in art styles as well. So that's why I drew something and then got a bunch of other people to color it to show that even when you use the same exact drawing, the same exact line art, with everybody's different coloring, it's all gonna look different and unique. I feel like I've over-explained it, but now you know. I will be showcasing all of my submissions, so please, if you see a submission, you know, an art coloring style that really speaks to you, please go follow that artist, comment on their stuff, support them. I will be crediting every artist that submitted their coloring, obviously, because that is the right thing to do. So please go support all of the artists in this video. And yeah. So before I showcase all of the submissions I got, I want to show you guys mine, because mine are the original colors, or, you know, what I pictured the colors to look like. This character was inspired by my love of 90s art and colors and patterns. So yeah, I thought it'd be super fun to use bright neon colors because I wanted to see how other artists interpreted those colors. Not everyone likes to use bright neon colors in their art. So how are they gonna do it? I gotta know. So there you go. This is my new boy. He's got no name. Here he is. Love him. And without further ado, let's get into the actual project. Unfortunately, due to how many submissions I received, I can't talk about all of them one by one, but I still want to showcase all of them. So I'ma just roll them across the screen like this, and occasionally point some out. So, coloring. The hues you choose, the color schemes you're drawn to, the tones and saturation levels that you use, that all plays a huge part in your art style. It also plays a big part in the mood of the picture, but that's something that we're not really going to talk about today. Warm and cool color schemes, or tones in this case, are my favorite things to notice. My favorite thing to notice. You can go to almost any artist and figure out what they like to use the most. So, like, for example, if you go through my art, you'll notice I really like to use cool colors, which are blue, violet, and I guess green counts as a cool color, but I don't use that too much. I especially like to throw in magenta, which is kind of, again, in between cool and warm. It gives it that pop that I really like to use. So we're gonna look at some examples of artists who use cool colors. Forgive me for mispronouncing your name, guys. A lot of you guys have very interesting usernames, and I am not good at pronouncing things. So, Alcremie or creamy, Al Creamy, Awkward Dozen Art, and Bungee are a few artists who chose to use some cooler tones for the colors that I had given them. There was a lot of blue and violet undertones used. Out of all of my submissions, cooler colors were more popular than warmer colors. It was a lot harder to find those examples, which warmer colors I'm going to show right now. Some artists that did use warmer colors were Hakudagu, Fizzy Ghost, and Octopus Juice. Warmer colors consist of red, orange, and yellow. And like I said, these were a lot harder to find than the cooler colors. I guess warmer colors just aren't as popular amongst my followers, which I totally get, because I hardly ever use warm colors. And what about you guys watching right now? Did you notice if you are more drawn to warmer or cooler tones? Looking through your art, you might be able to notice a pattern. Moving on to saturation, I personally prefer higher saturated colors. So that means colors are way more intense. Whereas desaturated colors are less vivid, and the more desaturated they are, the more gray they have. You're pretty much just adding gray into a color. Some desaturated submissions came from the artists Konnichiwa, Starry Bin X, and Mizariomi Art. The colors these artists chose to use are more grayed out, if that makes any sense. As you can see, some of these artists also use a higher saturated color to grab your attention. On the other hand, we have some great examples of higher saturated submissions. Artists like Jeffrey Killjoy, Blurry Kenda, and Melky T use colors that are very bright and vibrant. It can be tough to balance out high saturated colors in the beginning, but learning more about color theory helps a lot. Let's talk about one of my least favorite things about art, which is shading. There are a lot of different shading types, and every artist likes to use certain colors when it comes to their own shading. So let's look at a few different shading types and examples. The first example comes from Omlining and Skybeeb, who both use cell shading. This means the shading is flat and has a harsh outline. It's actually one of the more common shading techniques in animation, and I got a lot more cell shading submissions rather than soft shading, which is what we're going to talk about next. Yay! The second example comes from Gangrel Child and, I cannot pronounce these names, guys, Pralaja or Pralaha. It depends on what language you're talking about. Both of these use soft shading, although Gangrel Child does use cell shading for the hair, but soft shading for everything else. I actually had very few soft shading submissions, so it was a little hard to find any of these. The last examples come from Toroyamas and Grinses? I'm sorry, I can't pronounce your name, but I love you. Both of them use a combination of hard and soft shading. They also happen to both be my friends. Hi, friends! Look at their art. So beautiful. I only talked about the types of shading, but I didn't really go over the colors artists chose to shade. I tried to grab examples that use different shading colors from each other, but like, it wasn't always the case, but you know, it'd be like that. The video can't last forever, but I do want to show a few honorable mentions, I guess I'll call them. So from left to right, these submissions are from Ashy Paints, Softer Peach, and Sunflana. These artists use their coloring and shading techniques to change the picture overall. Like, just looking at their art, I mean, their coloring added facial structure, like clothing textures. They all just look so great, and yet they are all so different from each other. So that's why I just really needed to show these to you guys. Okay, so I've been talking for way too long, and it's time to end it. So thank you to all of the artists who participated. Sorry I wasn't able to single everyone out. You guys were all so skilled and wonderful, and I really appreciate you guys taking your time to participate in this project. I know I didn't make this obvious when I first, you know, announced this project to Twitter, but you guys are 100% allowed to post your submissions online, whether it's on Twitter, Instagram, Tumblr, like whatever you want. Totally fine by me. Tag me if you'd like. I'd really like to see all of them out there, but you don't have to. To everyone who is watching this video, please go and support these artists. I'm actually going to be uploading all of the submissions into a Google Drive folder, and each submission will have a direct link to the artist's account of their choosing. So seriously, if, you know, you're too lazy to go look these people up, all of the links will be in there. Go follow them, support them, all that great stuff. And I definitely recommend you all go through the folder, not only to support the artist, but to study the way they color and shade. You can seriously learn so much from studying other artists. I mean, that's, you know, that's how I became who I am. And that's how a lot of your favorite artists became who they are and how and why their work looks that way. I'm not able to talk anymore. I'll also include the link to the plain line art as well. So if any of you guys want to try coloring in my new boy, you guys can go ahead and do that. I don't think I'll be making another video like this. We'll see. Maybe I'll make a whole new boy and we'll do this over and, you know, maybe it'll be like a Twitter thing or whatever, but yeah, we'll see what happens. Anyways, it's time for me to be quiet and go to bed. So, thank you so much for watching. Thank you to all the artists who participated. Please be good outlets for me, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!